Okay, I'm just gonna get this. It's level 44, I'm level 63, but I'm gonna show you something. So I picked that up. Some sort of plasma caster. I'm gonna mod it. Because what do? I mod weapons now. And I've already completed the game many times over. I'm about, not as much as some of my friends, but I'm about 1,300 and something, almost 1,400 hours into Borderlands 2. So the only thing left for me to do is mod weapons, because I'm bored. But I'll show you how I mod it later. I'll let the guys know I'm gonna bail for a while. I'll be back. I have to modify something. Alright, and now, okay, so that's my character, that's my Necromancer. She's level is she? 63 or something? Where is she? Yeah, she's level 63. True Vault Hunter mode basically means that I've at least been through the game once, the entire game, so it's made so that, say if I'm playing solo, it'll scale up to my level, the enemies. Yeah. She actually is level 73, but I had changed her. I used the Gibbed Save Editor to make her lower so that every now and then my friends who are also high level, but they have level 47 characters, so I don't, you know, so if I want to play with them on the fly, I'll have a lower level character, for example. You know, I have one that's 28, even though technically, well, actually, no, this character actually, they bring after a level 10, but this character, I've made her that level before, but then after a while, I'm like, oh, I'll make it. Yeah, some of my characters are legit, some I just manufactured in a few moments, like this one is. I had her since the Necromancer character came out. I kind of stopped at 61 because I was doing other things. Death, yeah, he's my... Actually, I just made him. I did not make him legitimately. The Psycho, I did. My Commando is legit. So... yeah. Anyway, it's a mixture of stuff that I made, and just so I can get to the good stuff. I don't like Berserkers. I think I would, but I'm more of a commando between, you know, guys that are good with guns. Anyway, so we're going to go to the desktop and do a little modification to that gun I just picked up. Okay, so right now, we already opened up my save file for my Necromancer gauge. And so now we're going to go to the backpack section of it and look at that file, that the part that has the weapon that we picked up in the game, which happens to be the Impetuous Plasma Caster. You notice everything else is level 63, and that particular one is level 44. So even if I forgot, I'd have to remember, hey, the weapon I picked up was a lower level. So one thing I'm going to do now is just say sync all. That makes it so that everything is the same level. So I don't have to manually type it in, even though I have to change two things. You change it up here, the manufacturer grade, and down here, the game stage. So that makes it so that the damage that this will do will be appropriate for my level. Because the higher you get, the more damage it does. So a level 63 weapon would do more damage than a level 10 to the same creature. although a level 63 creature, me using a level 63 weapon may be, you know, it's proportional to somebody if they're a level 10 fighting a level 10 creature. So it's all proportional. Anyway, why not? And the next thing I'm going to change, the last thing, is its elemental damage. I'm going to change it to none. Since in Borderlands 2, the alien stuff is, sorry for, there's distortion on the screen, I just noticed it. The alien weapons do plasma. Combining that with the Malwan weapons always do elemental. Changing this to none, not because of that, it would do it anyway, but changing this to none, it's automatically going to be explosive. So this weapon is sort of hard-coded. This type of weapon is hard-coded to do some type of plasma in a way. So the fact that it does explosive means that it'll technically be doing two forms of damage, explosive and plasma. So it'll look kind of weird. In my experience, it should look sort of this hot pink color, and then it'll have these weird crystals that pop out, almost like geode crystals. And I'm going to save it back to Game Save 69, which represents my Necromancer. Yes, I want to replace it. I'm only doing it like this because I'm comfortable with it. I have backups of this stuff, so if I screw up, no big deal. Okay, so that's about it. I'm going to go back to the game and test it out. See what it looks like.
Insane, dude. They're just disappearing when you hit them with that thing.
So we're like level, you know, 63, 64 characters, but we're doing the attack on Digistruct Peak, or Assault, whatever the hell it's called. Since my weapon's doing in the millions of damage, they'll probably be okay, I think. Because they're noticing how things are just disappearing when I fire up. Yeah, my stuff's doing in the millions. I don't have a calculator. I don't know how much. But when you're doing like 8,570K, or that sounds weird. It's.
How I do?
That doesn't make sense what I said, but when you see it, you'll know what I'm talking about. When you see these numbers bouncing off these things, see? You see that where it said 1,119K, or yeah, it's millions.